class. Good morning, everyone. Today we'll be looking at the chapter 2, that is data center environment. In this chapter, we'll be looking at the core elements. As we have seen already, the core elements of the data center are: one is the host, the second one is the storage, third one is connectivity, fourth is applications, and the last one is database management system. And these all, how they are been helping in managing the data center. All these components are important. Please do remember, even if one component has been missing, then the data center working may not be proper and we cannot manage the data. The first one we are going to discuss is all about the application. So whenever I talk about the application is a computer program. There are so many applications in your mobiles, on your desktops, so many applications you have been installing. So what this application is trying to do is, it is performing the computer operations. Okay, and in terms of, it can be in terms of computing, it can be in terms of the game. So any application, it is performing your computer operations. Now when we are been developing these applications for the data center, then how they are being helpful, right? What are their what you say users, where it is being deployed, how it is helping a common person to get their work done. The first one is business applications. We have come across email, enterprise resource planning, and decision support system. Even in terms of management also, this has been applicable, such as resource management, performance tuning, and virtualization. Resource management, hope everyone knows that available resources, the computer has to plan properly, the CPU has to plan properly and give the resource to each and everyone whenever it is requested. And virtualization, though the the memory will not be available, but still it has to make sure that the memory is made available for the processes. And also in data protection, where we have been using as a backup, replications, and in security applications, especially in the authentication, antivirus. So these are all the applications that have been developed for a data center. Now when we are having these applications, there are various characteristics. For example, we are using for read and write. We have been using for the sequential and random access of the memories, right? So now there is one particular application he has been talking about, that is application virtualization. It is the technique of presenting an application to end user without any installation, integration, or dependencies on the underlying computing platform. That means we are not able to install, we are not into any installation, or we don't integrate. For example, is whenever you are whenever you are trying to install any application, in this application virtualization, it is not going to give any sort of an installation. It is not needed. For example, is our Google Cloud is providing us the Google documents, it is providing the presentation, it is providing the forms. So there is no need for you to install any particular documents, right? Like a Word, text, or MS Office, it is providing on its own. If in case you want to play any pictures and all, you have to install the app for that to run that one. Right, so that has not been necessary in the application virtualization. So you feel that the app is already installed, but though it will not be physically being present, but you feel that the application is available and you have been working on that one. Now this application virtualization, it is developed in a, sorry, it is delivered in an isolated environment. For example, the operating system is going to ensure that it is going to ensure that the integrity has been there, the security is being provided, and any versions have been there, it is getting updated on its own. Right. So I think if you might have seen in your mobiles also, you have been getting the updates each and every time. So you just click on that one, it has been installed. There is no necessary for you to go to the particular application and then install that. Right. So the next concept we are going to study about the database management system. So as all knows that database is a structured way to store the data. When I have all in the last class, I have been said that what is the meaning of the structured data and unstructured data. Unstructured data is a very haphazard data. You can't draw any conclusions. And even that data is, it has to be filtered. It has to be processed. But the structured data is already arranged in terms of the rows and columns. So in database, that is called as a tables. So this database, what is the benefit of arranging the data in the form of the rows and columns, that is tables? So it helps us to optimize the storage and also the retrieval of data. So it's very easy, just you give your USN, all your details are being available. But if in case I go on storing randomly your data, then I cannot optimize the storage because it will be all haphazard and it requires a lot of the storage. Now, DBMS, what is the benefit of having this one? Or I can say, what are the features? It's going to control, it is, what is that? You can create lots of databases, you can maintain it, and you can use these databases in any terms, in all the fields of the applications. Especially, it is going to instruct that operating system how to store the data properly. Right? So many applications have been there where you are using MySQL, you are using Oracle, you are using SQL Server, right? So these are all the applications that have been needed in the data centers to store the data in a very systematic manner. So I can say it in a very structured manner. Then the moving on to the next one is the host. So this was the first one. The host, when I say that means it is a computer. Okay, it can be your mobile, it can be your servers, it can be anything where it is going to run one particular application, right? And when I'm being saying it is going to run that applications, it may be having some other the resources also connected to it one. So examples here he is going to mention are the servers, mainframes, laptop, desktop, your tablets, your server clusters, etc. So these all the systems are being considered as host, your mainframe, mini frame computers, which are being processing or which are doing the lots of operations, right? These all are considered as the host or your computer system. And when I'm being saying these computer systems, obviously it is having the hardware and the software. Now, when I'm been talking about the hardware components, then obviously it is including the CPU. When I say CPU, then it is including the arithmetic logic unit, it is having the control unit, it is having the cache memories, where we have the different types of the caches, L1, L2, L3, so that the performance is being increased. I can say that the operation has to be performed at the faster rate. For example, is your mobiles is going in hand with the processor of the computers, where a few people use that one to play the games or online games, right? Video games. So for that video games, the processor speed should be more, right? The RAM speed should be more. Now your mobiles are helping you to play that one, right? For example, is a 4GB game, 5GB game and all. When it has been there, it needs lots of processor and that is being helped by your mobiles. And next one, we are talking about the memory. When I talk about the memory, it is your RAM memory and the ROM memory, which I can say they are your primary memories, right? The physical memories, what you have been talking. And the input and output devices, which are very much important to provide the input to the system, Then we have been having the software components, which is going to include the operating system. I can say operating system as the heart of the system. Any system you can take it. It can be your mobile, it can be your desktop or your laptop. Then we need to have the device drivers. Without the device drivers, no application is being run. For example, you want to transfer the data, then you need the Wi-Fi drivers. You want to connect any USB devices, you need the network drivers, right? So like this, the various drivers are being available. You want to hear the audio, you want to watch the video. For that particular, the device drivers have to be installed. Then we have been talking about the file system. I think if you see your computers, there is a file system where it is labeled as NTFS, if I'm not being wrong, which says that ENT file system. This is going to say us that how our files need to be arranged, right? So there are the various file systems given by the Windows. We also have the various file system given by the Unix, and then even the Linux also, right? So there are various file system, and the volume manager, how exactly you are going to manage your disk devices, right? So these are the things related to your host. Now, when I've been talking about the software, hardware components and software components, as I said, the operating system is the heart of the the devices, and even also the device driver is needed. Now, if you see that OS, when I say operating system, it is a set of the programs, and it is providing you an interface between the applications and the hardware. So if you people all remember, if you might have come across the operating subject where you have said that if this is the hardware, right, you have been having the hardware. Upon this hardware to run, you need the OS, that is operating system, and be upon this one operating system, you have been having the applications running, or I can say that is the host, right? So this is being needed for us. Now you can see that for every application needed to run it, we are taking the help of the operating system, which in turn operating system gives a command to the hardware to work according to the instructions provided by the user. Now, the various operations are being performed by this operating system, such as you can say that it is helping to control the environment, control the hardware components, manage the allocation of the hardware resources. Especially you will come to know this in terms of the pooling of the resources. When many requests have been coming, the deadlock situation have to be avoided. At that time, you will come to know that how operating system is going to manage that one. And in terms of the security, in terms of the storage management, in terms of the files, the device drivers, in case the network is not network issues are there, it is going to give you the error messages. So this all has to be managed by the operating system. Now, when operating system is doing so much of the work, then we are even moving to the something called as virtualized environment, where it is going to give such a environment virtualization, where he tells that we feel that operating system is doing all the things, the memory is being provided, and I can say that everything is going good, even though there might be some errors and all, right? Even this device driver, when I'm been talking, it is also, again, remember, these are all your softwares, these are all your applications that has to be installed. And even if one component, or even if in case you delete even a single file also, then the programs will not be working. That means the operating system will not recognize. You can check in your systems and all, it will be showing the device is working properly. All the files have to be available there, right? So these all are being needed in the operating system. The next, moving on to the next slide, is showing about your memory virtualization, right? The operating system is making us feel that our memory is larger, right? More than what it is available, whatever you keep on storing or you keep on trying to save the files, it shows, it pretends that yes, it is more available. Now what it does is, it is going to, when it is going to pretend, I said, that is nothing but it is like something virtualization. You have a very big file like 120 MB, 400 MB, then you have 1 GB and all. At the same time, the transfer of the data or the storage of the data, it has to be done, and the processing also has to be done. At that time, this virtual memory manager comes into the picture, right? You can see here the virtual memory manager is being there, who is going to help in all the operations that have been taking place. Now you can check in this figure, we have the operating system, we have this memory, right? And we have this disk drive. So the disk drive is the hardware, right? The drives what you have in your computer system, so that is your disk drive. Now when I'm been talking about this memory is nothing but is your RAM memory locations where you have been saying 4GB RAM, 5GB RAM. So this is acting as a RAM which is helping us to swap in and swap out, right? You can see here the swap in and swap out. Now what is this swap in and swap out? So if you people are very much aware, you might have heard the concept called as a paging in your operating systems. Right? What is this paging? So paging is nothing but it is again a program where you have been performing some operations, that is a file, right? You have been shifting it from a memory to the disk drive. Whichever memory spaces you have been using oftenly, then you have been using that one in the your memory, and then it has been transferred to your disk drive. As you all know that the disk drive is having the less speed or the performance is very low. So we take the help of this memory to have the faster operations, right? To transfer any data or you want to copy any data. At that time, we need to swap that one. So here when I say this paging, it is nothing but it is your file, right? Which has to be transferred very fast. You feel that it is not taking much of the time. Okay, chalo, it has been transferred to the disk drive, right? So this way, the operating system is going to take the help of the memory manager and it is going to transfer the data, or I can say the pages, from the memory to your disk drive. And as I've said that one, the access from your disk drive is very slow, right? Whereas and the flash drives you are using, you are using the USBs, the cache memories and all, it is very fast, right? So to store that one, to make the operation very faster, we are taking this help of the memory virtualization, right? And moving on to the next one. Right, we have a volume manager. In this volume manager, you can see that how the data is being grouped, right? You can make sure that the data, though it is a huge in quantity, how best I can save that data. For this example, they have been taking this one as a large volume manager, which is in terms of partitioning and concatenation. Now you can see here we are the host. These two systems are the host. So you can check here, this is the host, here we have another host. You can see this logic volume, that is where your drives have been there. Here you can see that you have been partitioning, you are having the three drives here, and then all together is being clubbed into one single disk, right, which is the physical volume, and this is the concept of partitioning. In this partitioning, you can see that when the host is sending, it is being stored in any of this. And later, it has been finally coming into one large volume. Now, the access is to be there, then it has to search from this one large volume and then has to be provided to the user. Here, when I say host, it is not only one person. There can be more than 1,000 people, right? Please remember that one. There can be more than 1,000 people. Now, a simple example is your Gmail. So many people are having your Gmail accounts. Now, when you give a username and the password, then it will never take less than 10 seconds to log in and say that either it is your correct password or incorrect password. Then how did this get it matched that every time your username and password is correct? What I'm saying is a very minute operation. Please understand, it's a very minute operation. So where this all will be stored? So that given the username, yes, this is the password and it is correct. And if you have been entered incorrect, then also at that time it is going to store that it is an incorrect and give you only the 3 chances. This is an operation. So please try to understand, when the 3 chances have been given, even after that also still it shows if you provide correct, then fine. If it is an incorrect, then again it is going to give you another set of the operations to be performed. Now, how all this is done at a very faster rate? So this is all the virtual memory, though you feel that it is being stored. Please remember, this will be all done at the back end. You can't see at the front. Then later it will be transferred to your disk drives. So the another one is the concatenation, where you can see here the large volume, right? We have been having a larger disk. From there, you have been transferring it to the different drives so that you feel that whenever the host are been performing the operations, they feel that the memory is larger, right? Okay, I have a more of the data, I have more memory size, then I can transfer it, I can store it. But at the back end, that is a physical where we are been dividing that one and we are storing. So I can say that this partitioning is just a reverse of your concatenation, right? In the physical volume, you have just one drive, but in the concatenation, you have all the 3 drives. But in the logical volume, you have just one volume here, that is one drive, and here you are having all the 3 drives, right? So this is all about the memory virtualization. Now I shall just show to you people how the virtualization is being done and how the file transfers are being there. Now you can see here the device manager, where you can see that you have the input and output, the batteries, Bluetooth, display adapters, disk drives, right? If I click on this one, the disk drive I'm using is Hitachi, and then I have a CD, DVD, drivers. You can check here, there is a drivers. Then for your keyboard also, you have been getting that one, the standard PS2 keyboard, right? And if I say here for the properties, right, you can check here, this device is working properly, right? So this is the driver, you can check here. It's giving you all the details. So update the driver, uninstall. If I uninstall, then my keyboard will not be working and the details is being provided. You can check here the device description, what are the hardwares, what is the status, the configuration flags, right? Driver version has been there. If I click on this one, this is the driver version for me. And the basic whatever I'm having, the device name and what is the power data. So currently what it has been there, right? So please remember, this is all being coded, right? Power state mapping, S4, D3 and all, right? And what else is there? Safe, removable, and you have been getting no install class. What is the rank, right? So the device stack is there. So the device stack ACPI, the port number has been there, 8042 port, KB, D class has been there. So the events, what is going to take place, what has been migrated, and the resources that I'm been sharing. Right, you can see this is the particular resources that has been shared. Right, when I'm been talking about this Hitachi, this is a properties. Let me check in this one. So it is saying my device is working properly. So what are the policies? What are the volumes I'm been having? Right, it has not been provided. Then the details. So let us look into these details. Okay, so the what is that? Driver version will look. So what is the driver version available? And what is that? We have the location information. So it's a bus target LNU. You can check this one. And anything else has been there which I want to show for you is a manufacturer. So it is a standard disk drives. Okay, so this is all available in your device manager. So this is all available through your operating system. So please remember that one. Then the next one that I want to show for you people is the disk management. Right, that I was been saying you people. The disk management, you can see here, the file system that we are using is NTFS, right? As I said, yeah, NT, the file system, the capacity it has been there, the storage. And you can see here the field, right? It is the blue color. And then here you are using E drive. So this is the volume. I was just mentioning the volume manager, right? So whichever you want, you can transfer it. You can now you can see this one 351 MB is unlocated. Now you can check here is a primary partition extended. And this is your logical drive, the free space available, and this is unallocated. So you can allocate, that is, you can merge the volumes, you can shrink the volumes from here. So there is, so this is a part of your virtualization. You feel that although you have been done it. So there is a simple volume. When I want to create another one volume, you can just change it. Now you can check the options on this one also. Like I can shrink this one, I can delete. So once I delete, whole my data will be lost. So please don't make such a mistakes, right? And anything else I want to show for you people. So how much percentage is available? What is the free space? And if you want to have the view. Any other options has been there. If you want to clean up any of the disks, there will be so many files available, so that also you can do it from here only. You can partition, right? Okay, so this is all I wanted to show for you people. Thank you.